Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim sharing with you Purified, a study of Surah Maryam, the 19th chapter of the Quran. Yes, I'll say that word again. Maryam, alayha salam, peace and blessings be upon her. A woman who was better than me and better than you. And that's a really important place to start. You know, this surah, subhanAllah, is a surah that gives this amazing, amazing discussion about one of the greatest women. In fact, probably the greatest woman to have walked the earth that we're informed of by name from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In many other places in the Quran, Allah describes her upbringing. Even before her birth, the intentions that her parents had before her, the cultural context that she grew up in. And, you know, I want you to kind of consider and put yourself in her place, that there's this person who had this deep connection with Allah. And that wasn't something that was enough to save her from being tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want that to be a backdrop to everything that we're going to talk about. That Maryam alayhi salam is a person whose dua is answered. The angels would deliver food for her that no one else on earth ate and had. That even prophets like Zakariya alayhi salam would walk in and say, "Anna laki hada, how did you get this? Where did this come from?" And she would say, "Huwa min indillah, it is arrived by the leave and the permission of Allah." That person yet had to endure public humiliation. She had to publicly endure being ridiculed and accused of adultery, fornication, of an illegitimate birth of a child, that she brought a child into the world without a father and a husband. It's a moment of difficulty that anyone would assume, but even more so if you were that person who had a standard in society that you would be compared to the actors of the Old Testament, like Harun alayhi salam, Aaron and Musa, and they would say to her, "Ya ukhta Harun, ma kana abuki imra'a saw'in." You're like the sister of Aaron. You were such a pious person. We can't believe that you would do this and shame your family and your father and your mother. And there's that lesson for us, that it doesn't matter how close you are and connected you are to Allah, there are certain hurdles in life that we must prove faith through. And there are certain steps that you and I must take to show our worth to Allah. Not to others, but to Allah. And Allah tells us, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الصَّادِقِينَ. Allah has tested all of the nations who came before us and made known through the tests that He has given those of them who were truthful and patient in their claim of faith in Him. Maryam alayhi salam is a story of immense sabr, of immense patience. And yet Allah quotes her saying, قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتْتُ قَبْلَ هَذَا. Oh my Lord, I wished I had died before I had never seen this day. Maryam, a person who the angels would speak to, who would greet her and make dua for her, deliver her food by the order of Allah. Maryam, who the prophets of Allah nurtured her and taught her. She was the one who would now make a dua, "Ya Allah, I wish I was never born." That's how difficult her test was. And that's something for you and I to reflect on and take so many life lessons from. I hope you will join me, inshallah, for Purified, where we critique and study and analyze and benefit from the life of Maryam alayhi salam. That's even before we begin speaking about her son, Jesus. Peace and blessings be upon both of them. Let's go on this journey of love, Purified, a study of Surah Maryam.